Good evening. I would like to introduce our Student Government Association President, Elena Camisa, who will lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance, and please remain standing for the singing of the National Anthem, performed by the Senior Chorale and conducted by Mrs. Jessica Mischke. Please rise.
I pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Oh, say can you see. So proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free,
Good evening. It's good to have you here. I am Dr. Samuel Thompson, proud principal of Farmingdale High School, and I want to welcome you all to this momentous occasion. Welcome members of our Board of Education, our superintendent, Mr. Defendini, and the members of Central Administration, district directors and administrators, including our two assistant principals, Mrs. Arlene Martinez and Mr. Jed Herman, and I especially want to welcome families, parents, friends, and students. I'd like to thank Mrs. Patty Ann Stallone and the administrative assistants, as well as the custodial staff, for their efforts assisting and organizing this ceremony. And I'd like to thank, of course, our senior class advisors, Mrs. Louise Corcoran, Mrs. Ann O'Brien, and Mrs. Suzanne Cerase, who have made the time for this class a memorable one for all. Thank you. For me, it is a great honor and privilege to welcome the class of 2019. Congratulations. And an important tradition at Farmingdale is to recognize our service women and men in this graduating class. I invite these individuals to stand and be recognized when you're called. Andrew Alves. Kayla Cheshire. Adriana Eugenio. Kevin Ferreira. Benjamin Finnerty. Thomas Hilbert. Sam Jonak. Brandon Rossetti. Ariel Alvarado Sandoval. And Samantha Torres. I would like to note that these young women and men have chosen to serve our country in the various branches of the United States Armed Forces. These individuals have committed These individuals have committed to protect and serve our country, and we thank you all for your service. Be safe, and we're especially proud to honor you. Please be seated. Thank you. I'm so grateful for the opportunity to be part of this momentous occasion. High school graduation is a tremendous accomplishment, and this is an important ceremony to mark it. I'm especially proud today to honor you, the Farmingdale High School class of 2019, as well as the parents, the faculty and staff, and the friends who helped make this day possible. And thank you to our Farmingdale Board of Education members and central administrators for your continued support. There's a specific phrase used over and over again to describe the Farmingdale High School class of 2019. They are really good kids. So let us reflect on what we've heard and why we have heard this term used so often for you. First, your scholarship includes College Board recognition, such as the AP Computer Science Female Diversity Award, and also the National Hispanic Scholar Award for a student whose cumulative GPA and score on the PSAT placed in the top 2.5% among Hispanic and Latino PSAT test takers in our region. You've demonstrated character. Our school, athletic teams, and coaches have received Nassau County Sportsmanship Awards for your self-control, your fair play, and your devotion to the rules of the game. We know that you will do the right thing when no one's looking. Your talent is recognized on national, state, and local levels in the arts. The class of 2019 has all national, all Eastern, and all state musicians. And you brought home gold recognitions for both individual and ensemble performances at NISMA. You've shown us your altruism. Where students in this class continue to spearhead efforts year after year since elementary school to fundraise for a cure for children with cancer. This year, participation led to a new milestone exceeding $1 million raised. In summary, your scholarship, character, artistry, and compassion for humanity have not gone unnoticed, and it underscores the phrase, really good kids. Also, it's important to consider what it took to get you here today. In a word, drive. Most teenagers consider the ability to drive the most exceptional accomplishment in their lives. Most adults might suggest the most exceptional accomplishment is when you drive your own car to your first job with benefits as a better sense of accomplishment. But what do we know? Your true drive is that you've been committed to a purpose which we are acknowledging today, high school graduation. The drive that it took to get here today, this skill that you're acquiring, will spur ambition and action for meaningful change. Your journey will encounter perpetual opportunities. Your ability to adapt to obstacles on the road to destiny is essential for you to continue to experience success. And as you drive to your destination, never be a mere passenger content with the status quo. This motivation will help you reach more checkered flags in your future. So, you're really good kids, because you've learned to value our school and to be accepting of those you encounter in the school community. The experience in our school community has helped shape who you are and what you understand about our world. Farmingdale has given you a sense of the common values and beliefs that unite us. As different as we are from one another, we're also more alike in many astonishing ways. But use this caution on this road. You will encounter ways that values and beliefs can unite us or even tear us apart. Most of us value love, trust, integrity. We care about honesty, patriotism, our heritage, and more. Treasure it and put these values first, and it will serve you well. Not only does your future depend on it, but that of our community, our country, and our world. At this point, your education at Farmingdale High School has shown you values, knowledge, and skills alone aren't enough. It's how we use the knowledge we gain that counts. Our world is filled with knowledgeable, even brilliant people. But you do not have to be smart to act on good principles, morals, and compassion. Yes, a genuine concern for the well-being of others helps define the phrase, really good kids. And if you ever need help, like I've said before, the door to Farmingdale High School is always open. You are an exceptional group of really good kids with tremendous drive, and we congratulate you and wish you only the best. Congratulations. I'd like to invite our Dean of Students for the senior class, Mr. Kevin Shanley, to address the class one last time.
Guys, congratulations to the class of 2019. Last night, unfortunately, I missed the banquet because my youngest son graduated right here at Hofstra, Massapequa High School. Hey, I know that's enemy territory, but that's okay because I don't like them either. And that includes my family. No, I actually like them. But I was sitting in the audience just like your parents, your guardians, family and friends. So I know the feelings of happiness and the special pride of accomplishment that they feel for you. Every 4 years, the dean of the class addresses the students for the last time. I have the honor to have shared this class with Mrs. Napolitano, who before her retirement was your dean for 9th and 10th grade. And she liked you guys so much, she's here tonight. Also with Dr. Mabry. You were very well liked. Graduates, be proud of yourselves. You accomplished a very important milestone in your lives. But don't forget to appreciate the people who helped you get here. Be confident that your educational foundation will serve you well in your future. It is important to seek guidance and ask for help. These are signs of strength, not weakness. In this room sitting before me, we have young people going to college, learning a trade, serving their country in the armed forces, and I really believe that our future is in good hands. Don't ever forget that the most important goal in life is to be happy, and I wish all of you nothing but a lifetime of happiness. Congratulations.
I would now like to introduce our assistant principal, Mr. Jed Herman, to the podium to honor our salutatorian.
Thank you, sir. Good evening, everybody. Yep, that's me. It is my honor tonight to introduce the salutatorian of Farmingdale High School class of 2019, Miss Jessica Finkel. Hey, you can come up. Jessica has earned this distinction by accumulating an overall GPA of 104.5. Wow. A truly amazing accomplishment, and one that she earned through both hard work and dedication. These two characteristics drove Jessica to choose the most rigorous courses along the way: humanities in 9th, 10th, and 11th grade, honors courses in living environment, chemistry, geometry, and algebra 2, AP European history, AP Biology, AP Calculus BC, AP English Lit, College Accounting, College Economics, and College Government. Yeah, that's a big feat. No easy task. While working hard in school takes up a lot of her time, Jessica still makes time for other activities. Jessica was captain of the volleyball team, helping the Lady Dalers to an undefeated conference-winning regular season this past year. Jessica was also captain of the softball team, splitting time between left field and the designated hitter. Jessica was a marching band section leader, a member of the All-State Symphonic Band, and also plays the French horn. Jessica also finished in the top 10 in accounting in the DECA State competition. And in her spare time, she likes to mentor the younger softball players. Now, while her resume is quite extraordinary, as I've gotten to know her, may I say that I think her most impressive attributes may just be her kindness towards others and her humbleness. So in summary, whether she's working hard for herself or for others, Jessica is an amazing young woman and Daler, and will no doubt find great success in whatever she chooses. In the fall, Jessica is taking her talents to Penn State University, where she will study engineering. Ladies and gentlemen, I proudly present to you Miss Jessica Finkel.
Wow, Farmingdale High School graduating class of 2019. If everyone for a second could give my classmates a big round of applause, because we did that. In 4 short years, we went from scared freshmen to strong, confident seniors, and at the end of the ceremony, we'll be proud alumni. Now, I could go on and on about how failure is just one step away from success, or that the journey is more important than the destination. But let's talk about the real purpose of high school. And sorry, Mom, it wasn't class. Sure, we learned important things like the Pythagorean theorem that we'll definitely need to help us get jobs and become successful in the future. Right, Mr. Drucker? Really, what we'll remember is not the tests, projects, and grades that we earned, but the bonds we formed with our amazing teachers, coaches, teammates, and friends, and the lasting memories we've created at Farmingdale High School together. I know that I'll always remember how it felt to go to a high school football game, watching the entire school cheer for our team, led of course by Dale the Lion, and seeing all of my friends in the bleachers. I'll remember the epic Halloween parade, how fun it was to see all of my fellow seniors dressed in such creative costumes, and the excitement of the Woodward Parkway students watching us walk towards them. And I'll remember the last day of school, seeing so many seniors in the Commons 8th period getting those last-minute signatures in their yearbooks before the final countdown, one period later, when we all left the school together for the last time. I'll treasure every second I have spent and every memory I have made with all of you over the years. Now, look at those faces around you. Those that sit beside us here at Hofstra are the same ones we have grown up with. We've done it all together, from the many Pacer tests, the infamous walkathon, the 8th grade Adventureland trip, the junior prom, the final homecoming, all the way to the senior banquet. Before the day is done, we'll be tossing our graduation caps and cheering together one last time. But this time, it will be to the end of a beautiful journey and the beginning of a blank page. This small but meaningful chapter of our lives may have gone by in the blink of an eye, but has shaped us into the people we are today. It may be hard to leave our beloved school behind, but I know that we all have an extremely bright future ahead, and from this point on, we can do just about anything. The world's at our fingertips, so I challenge you all to be who you want to be, live in the age of endless opportunity, and let's make each other proud. Thank you.
Thank you, Jessica. And next, here to present the Dr. Gary E. Karp Community Service Award is Board of Education Vice President, Mr. Ralph Vincent Morales.
Good evening. Gary Karp was a giving member of the Farmingdale community. He served this community through his local business, his position on the Board of Education, and his countless acts of service and kindness. This award is given to someone who exhibits similar qualities and always has the best interests of the school and the community in mind, and of course, in their heart. The true heart of a Daler. When reading the criteria for this award, it wasn't very hard to come up with a name. This young lady has been a significant member of the Farmingdale family. In addition to being a model student, she has been involved in many clubs and volunteer programs throughout her high school career. She has been a leader in the marching band and the chorus, a member of the Italian National Honor Society, and an officer in student council, all where she has donated her time before, during, and after school to help execute various community service projects and school activities. Additionally, this impressive young woman is part of a community service project called Birthday Wishes, where she bakes and delivers treats to children at local shelters, helping them to celebrate a birthday or a special day. She has also volunteered in a recreational program within our district for children with special needs. And she has spent countless hours volunteering for elementary and high school PTA-sponsored events. This young lady is a loyal and compassionate leader, and she's a doer. She has the ability to make a positive change in all that come around her. This young woman wishes to pursue a career in elementary special education, where she can continue to love, to lead, and to give. Her unconditional desire to help and her lion heart make Jacqueline Maltese the perfect recipient for this year's Dr. Gary E. Karp Community Service Award.
Next, I would like to invite Assistant Principal Ms. Arlene Martinez to introduce our Class of 2019 valedictorian.
Good evening and welcome, parents, families, members of the Farmingdale Board of Education, faculty, administrators, and our esteemed guests, the graduating class of 2019. It is my honor this evening to introduce you to our valedictorian, Kunj Patel. Kunj began his academic career here in Farmingdale as a student in the Woodwork Parkway Elementary. While he was in an elementary school, Kunj was a student who was learning English as a second language. Kunj worked hard since elementary school and viewed his parents' efforts as his source of inspiration. Kunj fondly remembers his mom insisting that Kunj complete his homework even when he had free homework passes. He also remembers bedtime routines when his mom would help him recite the multiplication tables. Kunj states that his father inspired him to work hard and dream big. Kunj saw his father transform himself from an employee to a business owner and boss. Kunj continued to work hard as he completed elementary school and middle school. While in high school, Kunj continued to keep in mind all of the life lessons he learned from his parents, older sisters, and teachers. He became involved in various extracurricular activities such as Science Bowl, Science Olympiad, Model United Nations, Marching Band, Pep Band, and became captain of the boys' tennis team. He also became the secretary for the Key Club, president of the Spanish Honor Society, was inducted to the National Honor Society and the Tri-M Music Honor Society. Kunj immersed himself in advanced placement coursework in English, biology, environmental science, calculus, chemistry, and history. Kunj also became involved in philanthropic endeavors, such as volunteering at a soup kitchen, the public library, and UNICEF. Kunj accomplished all of this and earned a GPA of 105.069. This fall, he will continue his academic journey in Villanova University as he majors in biology on a pre-dental track, and in the future will become an orthodontist. Kunj will take with him all of the lessons learned here in Farmingdale and will continue to receive the support of his loving family and of the Daler community. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me give a warm Daler welcome to Farmingdale High School's valedictorian of 2019, Kunj Patel.
Okay. 13 school years, 156 months, 4,745 days, 113,880 hours, 6,832,800 minutes, 409,968,000 seconds later, here we are standing at our final farewell departure from Farmingdale High School. The most climactic moment of our teenage lives has been reached. Now let me start off this speech by taking a moment to thank my classmates, peers, mentors, faculty and staff, but most importantly my friends, and my mom, dad, and my sister for helping me with my journey thus far. And especially, big shout out goes to my ultimate savior, Google, for literally helping me with any answer possible. Without the support of them, this journey truly wouldn't have been as successful as it has been for me and for all of you. Although I do acknowledge that this is a valedictorian address and one should probably mention something about themselves, I vow to be unique, and I believe this should be a moment for each and every one of you sitting beside the podium about to become a Farmingdale alum. This is the moment to reflect on the last several years as we embark on a new journey, one which will allow us to meet new people and branch out into the real world. This is an opportunity to take a moment to look at all the accomplishments you have made thus far. From the first time you learned how to walk as a toddler, or the first time you learned how to ride a bike or swim, or even the first time you stepped behind a wheel. Yes, I know, parents, this one was probably the most scariest. Although over time we have all earned our respective admirations through various aspects of high school, whether it be academics, sports, music, or art, we have all worked around the characteristic of determination. Yes, I know it's only a 13-letter word, but it holds a significant value. Whether you realize it or not, it has helped us strive in many ways. But it has created a hunger for success and what I call a disaster in the American schooling system. High schools have never failed us as educators, but we as learners have failed. High school has unfortunately nationwide become a competition where individuals believe having the highest GPA in their respective class will allow them to become the ultimate champion. But I vow to differ. Although I'm tremendously grateful for the title I've earned after countless hours of hard work, I believe I've seen individuals who are far more talented than me in areas I personally lack in. I believe as an avid member of society, I admit as a human, I have flaws. I'm nowhere near perfect. But I believe the route to success is built upon the courage and strength within one to work on your weaknesses. From this day on, I request each and every one of you to put your mind and soul to your desired goal, and hopefully one day it'll become attainable. Words truly cannot express how thankful I am to Farmingdale High School and this district, especially the staff and faculty, for adequately providing me with the resources to grow as an individual. I was once a young boy who grew up as a first-generation Hindu born to immigrants. Surprisingly, many people believe that as the valedictorian, I was gifted academically, but little do they know the struggles I went through as a kid born to immigrants. Throughout elementary school, I saw my fellow classmates strive and flourish academically as I struggled, barely able to pass New York State Common Core exams. But as time passed, it was I who needed to change. It was I who needed to put in that max effort to reach my max potential. With the help of my ESL teacher, I soon flourished in the English language and worked my way out of the program. Moral of the story is, if I could stand in front of all of you right now and give this speech as the valedictorian of the class of 2019, you can too work to improve yourself in any area you lack in to achieve your desired goal. Now, to the graduating seniors of the Farmingdale class of 2019, I appreciate every single one of you for making these past years some of the most enjoyable experiences of my entire lifetime. This is not an end, it's just a new beginning, or as many people have heard as a new chapter. Good luck to everyone. I wish all of you the best of luck in your future endeavors. Thank you for the memories. It was fun while it lasted.
Thank you, Kunj. At this time, it is my honor to introduce the class of 2019 president, Ms. Zahra Khan.
Ladies and gentlemen, family, faculty, and my fellow graduates of the class of 2019, it is truly an honor to speak to all of you today. As the final weeks of this school year drew to a close, I often found myself thinking about lasts. Our last spirit week, our last homecoming, our last day as high school students. It seems like just yesterday we were tiny little 5 and 6 year olds boarding the bright yellow school bus for our very first day of kindergarten. In a way, not much has changed since then. We're all dressed up, nervous and excited, as our parents snap picture after picture after picture, most of which will likely end up posted on their Facebook pages with corny but well-meaning captions. Today, I stand before you plagued with a wild mixture of emotions, a fact that I am sure many of you will be able to empathize with. Perhaps it goes without saying, but firstly, I am filled with an overwhelming sense of pride and accomplishment. It hasn't always been easy, and I'm sure that many of us weren't always sure that we'd actually be able to make it here to the finish line, but we did it. And for that, we should all be proud. We survived through 4 years of gym, grueling math classes, and countless tests, assessments, and quizzes. My complex mix of emotions on this day stem from the very fact that this ceremony marks the end of an arduous journey. Although I am anxious and eager to move into this next chapter of my life, there is one fact I simply cannot ignore. Farmingdale High School is my home. For the past 4 years, I've probably spent more time in this school than I have at my actual house. You can ask my mom, she'll exasperatedly tell you that it's the truth. During my time here, I've become as connected to the people of this school as I have to the building itself. It may sound duplicitous to say that I will miss each and every one of you, but it's true. Everyone here, in some small way, has shaped me into the person I am today. And for that, I thank you all. Behind each and every single one of us, there must be at least a dozen individuals providing support in a vast and unlimited number of ways. From our teachers to our guidance counselors, from our coaches to our mentors, and from our family to our friends, the support and encouragement we've received from you over the years has been invaluable, and for this, we're eternally grateful. The best way we can show our gratitude is to take all that we've learned here and use it, at the risk of sounding cliche, to change the world. The great thing about Farmingdale is the diversity of the people, all of whom exemplify a wide array of impressive talents and interests. Farmingdale has provided us with plenty of opportunities to explore and develop these talents. There are people sitting in the audience right now who are artists, coders, actors, dancers, and athletes. There are people who aspire to go into business, become neuroscientists, engineers, teachers, and many more. As I contemplate the extraordinary opportunities we've been given throughout the years, there's one emotion that seems to have overtaken the others: guilt. I'm guilty because the opportunities we've been given are the result of circumstance. We were simply born in the right place at the right time. We've been provided with access to a good education, to good nutrition, to a good community, to knowledgeable mentors, and so on. One might argue that access is the true key to success, and here, in this land of opportunity, access abounds. We are lucky to even have dreams for our futures. There are those who cannot even afford to dream in the way that we do. Like Kunj, and like many of you sitting before me today, my parents weren't born here. Both of my parents were born in Guyana, one of the tiniest and poorest South American nations. They immigrated here when they were about 7 or 8 years old with the rest of my extended family. They settled in the Bronx and Queens. They were poor and uneducated, lost in a country where they felt they did not belong. I know people always say their parents are their heroes, but mine really are. They never let anything stand in their way of their pursuit of the American dream. The odds were never in their favor, but they didn't let that stop them. They went on to attend college and secure careers in the business world and build lives for themselves. And through it all, they never lost sight of where they came from. They have taught me the importance of appreciating the opportunities you receive and making the most of them. They've helped me to understand that I'm lucky to be standing here. That not everyone is exposed to the same access that I've been exposed to, and that it is my responsibility to make a conscious effort to extend these opportunities to those who truly need them. The last emotion I'm feeling today is hope. We're graduating today. We're bright young adults on our way to brilliant and beautiful futures. Wherever you end up, I hope more than anything else that you're happy, and I hope that you make an effort to extend that happiness to those around you. Be sure to say thank you to those who have helped get you here today. Be sure to make your time your own, for time is far too precious to let slip away without a fight. I hope that I've uplifted you today, but I also hope that I've made you too feel a little bit guilty, because a little guilt isn't always a bad thing. I hope you take that annoying little piece of guilt and you act on it. Remember that although it may not always feel like it, you have the power to bring access to those who have none. It's our responsibility as the next generation of thinkers and problem solvers. As we enter this next phase of our lives, I challenge each and every one of you, including myself, to do what you love and do it passionately. I hope that you use your talents for the greater good, and I hope that you make every effort to reach your full potential. Remember to be grateful, remember to make the most of every single opportunity you receive, and most of all, remember to be kind, because kindness is what makes us human. Thank you very much for your time, and congratulations to the class of 2019.
Thank you, Zara. And next to present the Board of Education Award is our Board of Education President, Mr. Michael Goldberg.
Good evening. In Marcus Zusick's new novel, Bridge of Clay, Zusick's narrator describes one of his main characters as not just a life, but a life force. And that is exactly what this student is, a life force. Her presence is felt everywhere she goes, from the classroom, always an enthusiastic and willing participant, to the athletic field, she is the school mascot, to extracurricular activities, the Student Government Association president. When she bursts into a room, her energy is contagious, but more importantly, so is her positivity. She smiles, she cares, she treats people with love and respect, and she appreciates life. She affects everyone and everything around her in the most positive of ways. Her school and hometown spirit is unrivaled. As a freshman, she walked onto the football field and asked if she could be the mascot. 4 years later, she is Dale, Farmingdale's own fun-loving, full-of-life mascot. As Dale, she performs with energy and enthusiasm without any hesitation. As any athlete or fan will tell you, she's an integral part of every Farmingdale athletic experience. Everything about this young woman exudes Dalers. As SGA president, she is finding her voice and is everything a president should be. She wisely leads by example. She is a responsible student and is known and greeted with a smile by teachers and administrators alike. She is also humble, patient, and caring. It is impossible to be around this girl and not feel good about yourself. She is good to people, is concerned about the well-being of others, and never acts as if she is better than anyone else. Being around her just makes you feel better about the world. She has brought empathy, happiness, and a love of life and laughing to the entire Farmingdale community. She has made herself a part of this community and has permanently left her mark on anyone who has ever come in contact with her, which at this point is most of Farmingdale. We will all miss her when she graduates, from the superintendent to the teachers to the kindergartners she entertains as Dale. We would love to keep her here forever, but we can't be greedy. We have to share her with SUNY Cortland, and we have to share her with wherever she ends up after that. We may not know exactly what her future holds, but this is certain. She will be the heart and soul for whoever is lucky enough to be around her, much as she's been our heart and soul here in Farmingdale. It is my honor and privilege to award this year's Board of Education Award to none other than Elena Dale Camisa.
I would now like to invite our Superintendent of Schools, Mr. Paul Defendini, for his message to the class of 2019.
Good evening to my Farmingdale family. This is Paul Defendini calling on behalf of the Farmingdale School District. Today is Tuesday, June 25th, 2019. Due to today's inclement weather, there will be a delayed opening tomorrow, June 26th, 2019. Please be safe and have a great day. I figured that some of you may just remind me or remember me as the snow day guy, so I might as well just own it. In actuality, tomorrow is going to be a beautiful day and the first day for whatever new beginnings might await you. I would like to start by congratulating the class of 2019. You have all, in your own way, worked hard and suffered through adversity to get to this point in your life. Nobody lives 18 years without having at least a handful of struggles. Some of you have seen more than a simple handful. Even though this was only my first year as superintendent, I was able to get to know many of you, and your stories are awesome. Whether a challenge day, at concerts, in classrooms, on the playing field, or in the commons, it was a pleasure to get to know you, the class of 2019, on a deeper level. You are a special group, and as I told many of you, and your parents, I could only hope that my own children grow up to be as well-rounded and well-mannered as you. Before the year ended, I asked a handful of students what they will remember most about Farmingdale Schools. Here's what you told me. One student that I spoke to after the senior countdown said to me that he will always remember building the homecoming float and the feeling of togetherness that came by working with his fellow classmates and advisors. Another student mentioned that adopting baby Bella as an honorary member of the lacrosse team will live with her forever. Another senior spoke to me about the band program and how that gave him a sense of belonging, and that band camp was a lot cooler than he expected coming out of middle school. He actually revealed to me that the Newsday Marching Band Festival gave him a tremendous amount of pride and made the hard work and countless hours worth the while. One student who suffered injury after painful injury on the sidelines said to me that his years at Farmingdale were incredible, and he was grateful to have learned how to be a leader from the sidelines. Another lady reminisced about Challenge Day and how in one brief moment, all the issues that plagued her during her life were just a little less painful as she felt the love and support of her classmates and teachers when they put their hands up to pay her the respect and compassion she so richly deserved and needed. I remember. I have never been so... One more. One senior picked up the microphone on Challenge Day and told his fellow classmates that this was their school and that seniors had the responsibility to set the tone and that this year would be a year of acceptance and tolerance. I have never been so moved in all my life than to watch that kind of leadership and courage. Finally, another young woman took our mascot and turned it into something more, a symbol of pride that will be passed on from generation to generation and even won the Nassau County Heroine of the Year Award and the Board of Education Award, not as a star athlete, but as our humble mascot. I will say it again. It was an honor to spend this year with you and to watch you grow into the young men and women that sit in front of me here tonight. You are awesome. Give yourselves a round of applause. These conversations and moments make me think that our lives are a series of memories. Memories strung together in a way that provides a sense of connectedness and community. Farmingdale memories are unique. In Farmingdale, our memories are filled with a wonderful and rich sense of diversity and a sense of togetherness that is second to none. Our memories are about friendship and a desire to help each other when times are tough. Our memories are not only success in the classroom, but success on the playing fields, on the stage, in art galleries, at robotics competitions, and everywhere in between. Although we still have much to do and many opportunities for continued growth, in Farmingdale we get the big picture, and that makes us all better people. Even though you may forget my words here tonight, you will never forget the memories that you have made that have led you to this point. Treasure them. You have a lot to be proud of. Congratulations, and remember that wherever you travel, your roots will always remain firmly planted here with your Farmingdale family. Once a Daler, always a Daler. Thank you and congratulations.
Thank you, Mr. Defendini, and we will now begin the presentation of diplomas.
Kunj Patel. Jessica Finkel. Elena Camisa. Chloe Sheeran. I'm just going to read off of this, I think. Samantha Dunn. Emily O'Flynn. Kayla Polterek. Alexa Nicole Riggio. Jillian Sierra.
Zara Khan. Haley Kleinhans. Cameron Kopetic. Nicole Kaczynski.
Jacqueline Maltese. Stephanie Burkle. Abigail Danino. Riley Priest. Ashley Acevedo. Kiera Ackley. Jared Alamon. Alexander Almonte Cabrera. Ariel Alvarado Sandoval. Emmanuel Alvarez Lozada. Andrew Alves. Jason Alvidez. Janet Amaya. Thank you. Brandon Joseph Amirati. Christian Amirati. Gabriella Angelico. Shay Acaro. Francesca Argueta Zamora. Shannon Armstrong. Tyler Escatino. Julia Aspermonte. Thomas Bailey. Navkate Baines. Brandon Balcaceres. Michael Barletta. Brian Benavides. Christopher Benavides. Abigail Burge. Christian Bariloff. Leanne Bashirs. Winston Bethune Jr. Kishan Bavnani. Justin Bifolco. Omari Blackman. Nyasia Blaze. Monica Blanco. Vanessa Blanco. Bruce Blubsky. Matthew Bacino. Bocchino. Daniel Bowles. Nasir Bradley. Antonia Brienza. Kendra Buck. Alexander Burbano. Madison Burke. Caitlin Buttafuoco. Jimmy Bynum. Aaron Burns. Joseph Paul Caldone. Nicholas Anthony Caldone. Ryan Callahan. Kimberly Samantha Canales.
Carissa Capabianco. Sorry. Brandon Carbone. Sean Carney. Amrick Caron. Liam J. Carroll. Corey Castiano. Mario Castano. Sabrina Castellane. Christian Castiglione. Jason Matthew Cavanaugh. Luke Santoro. Jody Cepeda. Douglas Cervantes. Danielle Chan. Christopher Charleston. Joe Cheshire. Kayla Cheshire. Michelle Crisides. Victoria Crisides. Bella Sincata. Thomas Chaffee. Kyle Clark. Matthew Contarino. Daniel Conti. Kayla Corbusiero Grebstad. Tiffany Corcoran. Daniel Cordova. Lee Corrado. Leanna Rose Costello. Hope Castidis. Eric Coughlin. Matthew Crum. Julian Cruz. Sarah Erica Cruz. Alexander Cruz Reyes. Alyssa Crystal. Danielle Cunningham. Riley DeAndrea. Bryce Daly. Catherine DeMaria. Anna Decker. Nick Demery. Nicholas Demers. Laura Dentado. Nicholas DeRosa. Ebens Desir. Emily Diaz. Tyler de Blasi. Ava Rose DeCiro. Matthew DiPietro. Caitlin Dobson. Brandon Doles. Stephen Donnelly. Hannah Duffy. Katie Eleftheriadis. Michael Elfawal. Daniel Alumba. Brian Emmyholtz. Kevin Escobar. Myra Escobar. Adriana Marie Eugenio. Nairi Facey. Jonathan Feldman. Alexander Charles Felker. Hannah Fernandez. Randall Fernandez. Anthony Ferrara. Kevin Ferrara.
Am I doing Tucker?
Tucker Ferrity. Mark Fasolowicz. Amani Finnegan. Benjamin Finnerty. Shane Ferran. Christopher Frank. Ariana Fritzen. Kylie Fritzen. Gianna Galanudis. Sam Galasso. Michael Gomez. Matthew Alexander Gansey.
Congratulations.
Pedro Garcia. Frankie Gatto. Randy Lynn Gaumer Larson. Nathaniel Germain. Congrats. Salvatore Giacchetti. Christine Gillerin. Isaiah Gillespie. Samantha Giordano. Emily Gonzalez. Niall Gordon. Salvatore Gargone. Samantha Gavaya. Julia Graziano. Jacqueline Grigvorvic. Patrick Greishaber. Andrea Grijalva. Marissa Grimes.
Congratulations.
Michael Grossman. Marisha Gruska. Samuel Guerra.
Daniela
Guevara.
Joel.
Okay. Ed Nilsson Joel Gunera Zapeda.
Alex Heiko. Michael Hamburger. Christina Hassett. Brian Hayden. Jessica He. Christopher Heckman. Alexis Helrigal. Emily Hernandez. Jacqueline Hernandez. Adam Hess. Richard Hickes. Jessica Higgins. Thomas Hilbert. Emily Hink. Leah Hodes. Anastasia Hoffman. Glavins Hogarth. Kyle Horseman. Samantha Hosking. Syed Hussein. Nicholas Hines. Ryan Hines. Alex Inkpen. Amber Innes. Dante Interlande. Jaeja Jameson. Jonathan Janicki. Brady Jethergian. Paulina Jimenez. John Johnson.
Congrats.
Sam Jonick. Kevin Jones. Rebecca Joseph. Tanya Joshi. Nicole Kalinowski. Megan Kane. Alyssa Kevin. Kayla Clockler. Daniel Knight. Amanda Kukis. Liam Kretschmer. Philip Krapata. Tiffany Kudrick. Madison Culler. Catherine Kunzman.
Just leave these here?
Yeah, I think just leave them.
Jamie Lagatuda. Jonathan LaRosa. Clifton Latobodere.
Charlene Lemonel. Jason Lenski. Madison Leon. Michelle Leverich. Will Lewis Flood. Alexander Liebau. Nicolette L'Hospitalier. Michael Lowell. Matthew Lutz. Anahi Loy. Connor Lynch. Jack Macaluso. Kaylin Machado. Julianne Malinowski. Anthony Malizia. Anthony Mancini. Jessica Manhopt. Kelsey Manzo. Thomas Moraldo. Maria Marquez. Kieran Marrero. Fernanda Martinez. Martinez. Jonathan Martinez. Wally Martinez. Nicolette Massioli. Delia Masterson. Matthew Matarese. Jane Metzel. Anthony Mazzella. Matthew McCaffrey. Emily McCarthy. Molly McDonough. Sean McKnight. Jada McFarlane. Jason Melendez. Sarah Ann Manella. Christopher Merriam. Nicholas Meyer. Nicholas Mazzapella.
Let's go, Nick.
Jason Miller.
Thomas Mokia. Michael Malloy. Robert Mangiatore. Sydney Moore. Shadia Moran. Dominic Morana. Elizabeth Morera. Alyssa Moritz. Daniel Mosley. Alexandra Mott. Olivia Mott. Brendan Murphy. Wajia Nawaz. Sebastian Neera. Cody Nelson. Tyler Nemesek. Charlie Wynn. Paul Norris.
Matthew
John How better? Gregory Olson. Kayla Olson. Nicholas Olson. Anna Lee Orellana. Anthony Orellana. Katherine Orellana. Taylor Osoy. Kelly Palandro. Stefan Pangolorias. William Pantaleas. Daniel Parenti. Susanna Perona. Jessica Pathmanathan. Connor Patterson. Sienna Patterson. Malaya Pearson. K. Catherine Pepitone, Jacqueline Perez Arabana, Maria Pagal, Victoria Rose Pinna, Jacqueline Pinna, Frederick Plans, Aiden Portillo, Christina Perovimo, Brian Quinn, Nader Rabi, Bernard Rafer, Mateo Ramos.
Vinia Ronnie Rapelli, Kiera Rasp, Victoria Racine, Caitlin Reddy, Justin Reese, Nicholas Rella, Nicholas Retzelis, Justin Reyes, Melanie Reyes, Angie Rivas, Olivia Rivera, Aaliyah Rivers, Kayla Robinson, Keith Roden, Ivan Rodriguez, Yesenia Romero, Henry Romero, Emily Christine Rose, Brandon Rossetti, Alberto Ruggiero, Sergio Ruiz, Christian Rupert, Patrick Ryan, Sarah Sackman, Vince Salvador, Ariana Samuel, Andrea Sanchez, Jillian Sanchez, Moses Sanchez Rodriguez, DeAndre Sandy, Gianna Santangelo, Rafael Santiago, Maria Santos, Eric Sattler,
you better thank them, teacher.
Sarah Scalarini, Anthony Shiano,
if I can pronounce Joseph.
Joseph Schuler, Tina Sagal, Christopher Serrano, Justin Serian, Adriana Sevilla, Talia Shakur. Yannick Shaw. Ahmed Sharif Ali. Aaron Shimborski. Noemi Zavala. Anthony Simeone. Michael Simeone. Joseph Simons. Sophia Sindicic. Ashraf Sheikh. Justin Sippel. Dimitri Smith. Isabel Smith. Patrick Smith Jr. Kyle Sukraj. Samantha Soriano.
Alexandra Spatero. Brianna Spouses. Matthew Stapleton. Patrick Stapleton. Nicholas Starkey. Avery Stevenson. Joseph Strano. Vincent Strano. Jessica Sudak. Sean Sullivan. Dean Surreal. John Sutera. Madison Talbot. Jacob Taramina. Juan Tejada. Lenezra Theodate. Olivia Therenas. Kelsey Thompson. Gabriella Toma. Samantha Torres. Shirley Torres. Michael Trachia. Gabriella Judith Umanzor. Dori Urina Peguero. Jonathan Valbuena. Mia Valenti. Matthew Valero. Monica Valisilos. Monica Calderon. Andrea Vargas. Juliana Vega. Jordan Velasquez. Sarah Kate Vela.
Really?
Bobby Vince. Gianna Vientri. Alexander Ventura. Anna Vergara. Angelo Vessio. Lindsay Vietri. Gabriella Vallejo. Ulysses Villatoro. Gianna Vitelli. Amanda Weber. Julia Witch. Matthew Widmere. Jabari Wilkes. Tiana Genevieve Williams. Brett Williamson. Timothy Wilson. Sabria Witter. Luke Woodland. Vitaly Yenzer. Jack Zalatel. Matthew Zambrano. And last but not least, Connor Zanellati.
So at this time, I present to you the graduating class of 2019. And I'd like to invite our graduates to stand and face your families. And now, by the power vested in me, with each senior having received a Farmingdale High School diploma, I certify to the Superintendent of Schools and the Board of Education that each member of the class of 2019 has successfully met all standards and requirements set forth by the New York State Department of Education and Farmingdale Public Schools. So I ask that you now transfer your tassels from the right side to the left side and congratulations, you are graduates. Thank you all for joining us. The graduates will assemble outside, and congratulations again to the Farmingdale High School class of 2019.